The Integrated Cardiovascular Experiment studies heart mass and rhythms to glean information about cardiac atrophy. That's a decrease in heart muscle that's seen in some astronauts when they return from long-duration missions. Here's what one of the co-investigators of that experiment had to say about it. Tell us about the Integrated Cardiovascular Experiment.
Well, it's pretty extensive, and that's why they ended up giving it the name Integrated. But we're looking at a diverse number of cardiovascular parameters and how they change with space flight, and how changes in the heart function or the heart structure will affect the ability to do exercise, will affect the ability to stand after return to gravity, and what influence that might have on the generation of cardiac rhythm disturbances.
Tell us what you've learned.
We've learned that if you measure the change in the amount of work, heart work now, not physical work, but cardiac work, that's done in space versus on the ground, because the theory is that in space your heart is doing less work than it's doing on the ground. But if you measure that change in work, and then you can relate that directly to how much mass or how big or small the heart is in a change in cardiac mass. So we've verified that, and we've seen changes in heart size in the astronauts from pre-flight to post-flight. Then our secondary goals for the experiment are to look at those changes and see whether these reflect in changes in their ability to perform in an exercise regime, or their ability to perform in standing upright pre or post flight, or does it relate to the generation of any, as I said, cardiac rhythm disturbances.
Tell us about Earth applications that this may bring.
Right. Well, we think it does have some applications to the Earth. Particularly, we've had for decades, NASA has used bed rest as an analog for space flight, particularly as it relates to the cardiovascular system. So this may have implications for those people who are otherwise relegated to sedentary positions, either because of injury or because of disease, or there may indeed be some parallels between people who have heart failure and decreases in cardiac mass that we might see with space flight. So we're looking to make those kinds of analogies in the future as well.
So if you make those analogies, you can come up with what?
Well, you know, there's certainly a whole lot more people on Earth than there are in space. So if there are either equivalent situations on Earth that could help supplement our knowledge base for space flight, or conversely, if in order to prevent some of the changes we see in space flight, we develop certain countermeasures, these may be applicable as, I'll put in quotes, treatments in the clinical environment here on Earth.
And the Integrated Cardiovascular Experiment concluded recently with Expedition 35's Tom Marshburn as the last test subject. A total of 13 astronauts participated in this study over the last few years, and we look forward to hearing results in the coming months. For more information on this and other investigations, go to nasa.gov/station. And as we take a live look into the Payload Operations Integration Center, Tim Horvath is at the helm today as the Payload Operations Director, and they are supporting the Robonaut 2 activities today. And that will do it for us from the Payload Operations Integration Center. Now back to you at Mission Control in Houston.